Alright, so here we have the Elka Panther plugin by Martinic. This is actually modeled after the 300 and 100 models of Elka Panther. And you can switch between the two modes over here in the settings tab. So, go to 100, go to 300. Let's go over all these controls on the front. So leftmost, we have the on-off button. On, makes sound. Off doesn't. To the right of that, we have the bass volume. Now this is actually controls the volume of this lowest bass octave. It does not control any of the other octaves. To the right of that, we have these various organ stop mix knobs. So these correspond with the numbers over here. So we have 16 foot, 8 foot, 4 foot. Turn this up to increase the volume of these knobs or switches right here. Turn up the volume of the 8-foot ones. Turn up the volume of the 4. You can mix these to get whatever organ sound you want out of all these switches. And to the right of that, we have this mixture knob. This is actually the volume knob for these two switches over here, so we can enable mix 1. Let's go up an octave. You hear that introduces a new tone. You can use all these knobs to get a variety of sounds out of this little plugin right here. So let's move on to these black switches. So this is a bass extension switch, which means if I turn this on, it will extend this lowest bass octave into the gray keys. So this will be a higher version of this. So by default, with this off, it's just a lower version of the white keys. Let's turn that on. See, those don't sound alike at all. It's more akin to this lowest bass octave. And to the right of that, these two switches are just tonality shapers for the bass octave, so it's more mid-range saturated sound. It's a lower, smoother tone. To the right of that, we have tremolo controls. So make it heavier and faster, or slower and lighter, or we can disable it. And to the right of that, the final control, we have the tone decay on or off. So let's go to the settings tab, and you can see the control right here. We have it on, and up here we have the decay time knob. This controls the time it takes for the tone to decay. So let's listen to what that sounds like. So let's have it shortened and extend it. Let's turn this up. And you hear how that mix switch just fades out as the time is up? It's more transient, like when you have lower time constants. Now let's move on to some more controls. So all these are the same as on the front, up to swell, which is just a volume pedal. And to the right, we have some pretty neat controls. So we have a guitar amp simulator, a spring plate reverb, tremolo controls, guitar cabinet emulation, and just the master. Let's turn that down because we're going to be introducing distortion, which will louden our sound. Let's drench this in reverb. Enable tremolo, turn down the depth. Let's turn this to the internal cabinet. So what I want to do with the depth is assign this to a MIDI knob on my keyboard. So I'll hit MIDI learn, select depth, move the knob on my keyboard that I want to control the depth knob, and disable MIDI learn. So as you can see, this knob's moving as I move the knob on my keyboard. So let's listen to what this sounds like. As you can hear, you can get some pretty cool combinations out of all these controls. Now, at the top right, well, first of all, let's disable some of this. Or now we can move on to the top right. So we have a noise level knob. This is actually just static noise from the synth. So turn it up. So as you can see in here, there's just more noise. And you can mute it by turning it to zero. Now this key contact section. All right, so in the white keys, if you play lightly, you'll hear that it kind of, it's like a da-da, da-da. It's like a very short feedback delay. Let's listen to that. You can hear it's like da-da, da-da. Now you can control the attack release and click of that. Let's use the attack to bring the delay or key contacts closer to the actual sound. Now you can't even hear it, but as we move the attack, you can hear the two separate. Alright, so let's go to this box sitting on top of the Elka Panther. This is actually Lem Echo. It's another plugin by Martinic. It's like a delay. And we can use that to create more space with our sound combined with this reverb. So let's turn up the reverb, turn on Lem Echo. I'm going to turn off the first tap and turn up the mix volume. Let's also get rid of the noise. We can actually change the EQ settings for each side, so let's do like a bass boost, treble reduction. Not much bass to work with when we're playing. When you play the high notes, you don't have much bass to work with. But yeah, this combined with the reverb can be used to give your sound more of a space. Can be used to great effect, but not maybe with this many notes playing. So let's finish this off by going over some of the presets. And as you can hear, this synth has quite a large variety of sounds. And I believe I forgot to mention that there's actually pitch shifting capability. So if your keyboard comes with a pitch shifting knob or buttons, like mine does, you can actually pitch shift while playing. Up and down. Well, the original Elka Panther didn't have that capability. Martinic added it in their software version. Which is very neat for live playing. You can do some interesting stuff with that. But anyways, that'll wrap it up for this overview of the plugin. You can actually pick this up at martinic.com. And I'll just leave it at that. I highly recommend this little synth. And I hope you have fun using it. Alright, goodbye.